Hey everyone, this is the Lego City Sweeper and Excavator set. It tries to pack a bunch of functions and play possibilities into one single set, so I'll go through each of the major assemblies one at a time. First up, the truck has very large tires, it's very high off the ground, and it has a pretty stubby nose on it, making it look like a modern style of Unimog to me. Unimog based chassis, that style of vehicle, and they have the sweeper bar on the front, which is removable and you can also angle it. It's actually attached with a ball joint right underneath the bumper or at the bumper, and that allows you to angle this off to the side appropriately to either side. And they also have ball joints attaching kind of in the middle, so you can change the angle just a little bit more, get a little bit lower to the ground overall. I don't know if that's really all that useful, but it does ensure that no matter what, you're going to be able to get this thing onto the ground nice and flat. And like I said, it is removable, so if you don't want that to be on there at all, they don't give you a place to put it just by itself, but that turns it into just a basic truck, which I think actually looks even better like this. I like the sides here. It's a little bit of a step detail for your figures to get up to it, and it also has spots to hold on to some tools in the back of it, and they include those tools, which is a good thing. Now there is a ball hitch on the back of the truck as well, so you might think you could attach this back there. Well, you can attach it, but this is the type of piece, the older style of piece, that doesn't have any friction in it, so this would just flop around loose back here and it doesn't really store it in place. The cab features opening doors, small ones on the sides, and to get easier access for us huge figures to get our minifigures in there, you can take the roof off as usual. And inside, well, it's just a flat space in there, but the steering wheel is offset to one side rather than being centered, so that's nice. It looks better than having it centered when you put a figure in there. You can get two figures to fit in here, but it's very awkward and it's a very tight squeeze. You need to have one of them with their arms way up in the air and the other one with the arms way down. It's possible one needs to be leaning forward. It's awkward, but works best with just one figure. They went with a wheeled excavator design, and it's nice and rounded around the back like modern excavators tend to be in order to fit into small spaces, so you can turn the whole thing around 360 degrees. It's very stable with a wide base that it has, and it has a couple of articulation points on the arm here, so you can bring this in pretty close. They use a very wide bucket on it, which is not the standard of what you would normally see at construction sites, but I believe they do that for the sake of play in order to be able to scoop up large actual Lego bricks. So this does have the ability to scoop things up. You know, you can bring a load up and then, you know, dump it off somewhere. You can also turn that bucket around if you want to use it as a front loader or take off one or more of the pieces here just to kind of shorten things up and turn it into more of a straightforward front loader. And to get easier access into the cab, you can just open this up, just rotate it back. Person just sits there in the middle and they get two control sticks. Set includes a basic trailer, which can be hitched up to the back of the truck. Fits just right there. And it has the gate that can be brought down here to allow you to just roll the excavator right up onto it. And the pieces that are in there help to lock this into place. So you roll this right up to that point, it's going to stop, and then bring the bucket down, bring the gate up at the back, and everything's just going to be held right there, so it's not shaken around and doesn't want to roll off or spin around on its top. The minifigs really aren't anything too special, right? But I think they look good. They're appropriate. You know, they got the high visibility theme going on. They've got some metallic printing in them. Good torso prints, I think, for each of these. This is a dual molded head, existing piece, or head add-on with the hair and the hat together. And this is also the second version of the construction cap with the ear protection on there that cannot be removed. Last up, they had just, I guess, a little bit of part budget left over when designing this. So here's a little bit of a piece of an old building that's being torn down. You can take pieces of this apart and then scoop them up with the excavator, a little construction zone sign, and then a couple of cones to help with traffic control. I fundamentally like the look of this truck. I would have liked to have this as a kid. I like having it now as an adult collector, an adult fan of Lego. You know, it looks like a toy, but it looks kind of realistic at the same time. It strikes that nice balance. I think that the color scheme is nice, even with the yellow. At first I thought the yellow might be a little bit awkward, but it just kind of looks like it fits in, to be honest. And they have the offset position for the driver. Of course, if you live in a right-hand drive country, you can just swap those around, and it just looks so much better having it offset rather than putting it in the center. I also really like the texture of these side pieces. I can never get enough of those. They've been used for many years. And the ability to hold all of these minifig accessories is a good thing. On the same token, this whole area back here doesn't dump. That's a big miss, I think. You know, they brought in the sweeper bar and stuff that's optional, that adds functionality to the truck, but there's no ability to dump it. So if you put stuff in here, the only way to get it out, well, you can bring the side gates down a little bit and kind of sweep stuff off, or you can, as a huge figure, come in and grab the whole truck and just dump it off like that. But I think it's a real miss to not have a hinge set up in there to allow this to dump the, you know, the dirt load out. I also personally don't like this. I don't like the look of it, and I don't like the build of it. Looks like it's trying to be a big wheeled forklift when you look at it just like this. Being able to spin around is good, having articulation in the boom is good, but it's a little bit awkward to play with this, I find. You're trying to bring material into you, but then it's not able to even bring it up to the level of the truck. So if you're holding something there, what are you going to do? You again have to, as a huge figure, come in, pick up the whole thing, even just to load items onto the truck that's included with the set. So doesn't look good to me, and actually doesn't play as well as you would think. It actually works much better when you take a couple lengths out of the boom and just use it as a front loader. It's a little bit awkward looking there, but at least it works. You can pick stuff up with it at this point, get stuff in there, lift it up, and then dump it into the truck. So you just bring it right on over and kind of shift it off, and there you go. See, that works. So a bit of a mixed bag with this one. I thought I was going to absolutely love it. I still like the look of the truck a lot. I like the look of the whole thing when it's all packaged up, and the little accessories are cool. The minifigs are good, but they definitely missed out on some important things for play, in my opinion. Just my opinion, though. If you disagree, please let your thoughts be known. Or if you agree, that's okay too. You can still leave a comment down below if you would like to. Thank you for watching. I hope this was a good video for you. Useful, entertaining, informative, or something of value. I'll be talking to you again soon in my next one.